Is our obsession with killing germs actually killing us? Dr. Leo Galland gave an eloquent explanation at our functional forum in September.
The story really starts with laboratory animals that have no microbiome. They're called germ-free. And the research that's been done on the behavioral effects of being germ-free are really eye-opening and, strangely enough, very relevant to humans, as I'm going to describe to you. Germ-free rats and mice are born and raised under totally sterile conditions. They have no bacteria in or on their bodies. And the first fascinating observation about germ-free animals is they require really intense nutrition in order to grow and look normal. They can't survive on ordinary laboratory chow. The reason is that your microbiome is feeding you. It's supplying some nutrients by producing them, and it's helping you digest and absorb other nutrients. That recognition led to the look for a link between obesity and the microbiome. Now, the second really important finding was that there are very few chemicals circulating in the blood of germ-free animals compared to conventional laboratory animals. 99% of the chemicals that are circulating in your blood right now derived from the microbes in your body, not from your own cells. Of course, the immune systems of germ-free animals are fairly lazy and not very well developed. That's not surprising because the best known effect of the microbes are to tune up your immune system, but it's the behavioral effects that are really fascinating.
Thanks for watching, and for more great clips like this, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. I've created a special free video just for you. It's called The Simple Prescription to a Thriving Practice, and it'll give you some starting points on how to build a strong, sustainable, community-focused practice. All you have to do is sign up and click the link below.